sports betting has bipartisan support here at the state capitol, and bipartisan opposition for that matter. But everybody involved understands it's a lot more complicated than just convincing the people here in St. Paul.
Minnesota shouldn't be an island, one of an ever-shrinking number of states that doesn't allow sports betting. It should be legal.
Representative Zach Stevenson of Coon Rapids chairs the House Commerce Committee. He points to the fact that 32 states, including all of those that surround Minnesota, already have legalized sports betting.
Relying on shady websites or digital workarounds to do what our neighbors in Wisconsin, Iowa, North Dakota, and South Dakota can all do safely and legally isn't right. It isn't good public policy.
Details are still being hammered out, so it's not clear if it would allow for mobile apps or only sports betting in brick-and-mortar establishments or only at tribal casinos.
I think it's safe to say I wouldn't be standing before you today if I didn't think there was a way that we could get a policy together that works for a very broad segment of Minnesota.
There's already been movement over on the Senate side. Republican Karen Housley and Democrat Carla Bigham are happy to see the House join the effort.
It's so much fun, and to see what it's done for the bars and restaurants, and see the excitement and the busyness on game days, whatever it is, if it's PGA golf or if it's the NFL.
Also, Minnesota is one of the top destinations for tournaments, and we're one of the only states that have professional teams in every sport, men and women.
From the Minnesota Indian Gaming Association today, the tribal governments making up MIGA have been examining the various ways sports betting has been implemented across the country and its impacts on tribal communities. As gaming experts, tribes stand ready to share this expertise with lawmakers considering the future of sports betting in Minnesota. Minnesota's tribal gaming compacts are among the strongest in the nation. They have no sunset clauses, so they can really stay in effect forever or until the tribes decide they want to change them. At the Capitol, John Crowman, CARE 11 News.